As another month of 2021 has passed, it is once again time for the monthly Rust update, which you probably want to know everything about. So in this video, I'll be showing you everything you need to know about the March 2021 Rust update. The biggest addition coming to Rust this month is the workcarts and the tunnel system for them. Workcarts are drivable underground trains which can fit around 15 people including the driver. You can find two of them at every station, which are clearly marked on the map by these train icons. At these locations, you will find a building like this on the surface. These buildings don't have any radiation whatsoever, so you can go down to the tunnels without any gear if you feel like it. These tunnels also have decent lighting, so you don't necessarily need a flashlight to be able to see down there. Heading inside, you can either take the elevator down or you can walk down the stairs, but the ladder is not recommended as you have to walk around 25 stories to get down. Once you're down, you need to kill a few tunnel dwellers to get to the station. Tunnel dwellers are the hostile NPCs that have taken up residence in the tunnels. They have M39s and M92s for weapons and 125 health. And just like scientists, upon being killed, they drop some low tier loot. Once you've cleared out the tunnel dwellers, you can proceed to loot the station as these stations have regular crates, military crates, and tool crates lying around. Once you've looted the station, you can get to either end of it to get a workcart. Workcarts run on low grade fuel and are quite fuel efficient, so a moderate amount of fuel should be enough to traverse the map. While going along the tracks, you will sometimes come across junctions where the track splits in two. If you do nothing, then your workcart will continue going forwards, but if you want to switch track, all you need to do is hold down A or D depending on which way the split track is going. You will also come across these openings filled with tunnel dwellers that also have a few things blocking the track. You can easily go through these at maximum speed, but as you're nearing these, an audio alarm will sound and hitting them will damage your workcart. Shooting the engine of a workcart will greatly reduce its maximum speed for a few seconds, so use this fact for workcart PvP. Workcarts have 1000 health and can be repaired with a hammer at a cost of 3 metal fragments per 60 health. They also don't decay over time. As all stations are filled with tunnel dwellers, you should plan a route that passes through the least stations possible to get to your destination. You can open the map while you are underground to view the map of the tunnels, and the name of the closest monument is also written on signs inside all stations in case you don't want to open your map. And once you've reached your destination, to get back to the surface, all you need to do is follow the exit signs, kill a few tunnel dwellers, and ride the elevator back up to the surface. Also, as a side note, I'd like to mention that a player doesn't have to be in the cab for the workcart to keep moving, and the workcart will automatically stop if all players jump off. Three slot machines were added to the back of the casino in the bandit camp. To play, all you need to do is sit down, deposit some scrap, and start spinning. A spin costs 2 scrap, and on screen now you can see the payouts for the different roles. The price of drone deliveries was changed to a flat rate per order instead of increasing along with the quantity, so now you'll only have to pay 20 scrap per order at the drone terminal. We also got a new set of Twitch drops this month. The streamer specific skins this month, which you can earn by watching each streamer for a total of 2 hours, are the Iris Xar, the Banan's sleeping bag, the Swale's metal face mask, the Shroud pants, the Root AR, the Albin MP5, the Recoil 23 Garage Door, the Blueprint SAR, and the Deathwing MP5. And the general Twitch drops, which you can get by watching Rust on Twitch for a total of 2, 4, and 6 hours respectively, are the Vice Gaming Hammer, the Will Joom Hide Poncho, and the Twinkle Cave Wooden Box. If you'd like to find out how to get Twitch drops, click the card in the top right corner of your screen now. Finally, here are a few additional changes that were made this month. Small boxes can now be placed under mixing tables. The radiation from all electrical substations, both big and small, was removed. And riding on a horse should now be smoother when riding on rough terrain. So that's it from me, I've been Meemish, and if this video helped you, consider leaving a like and subscribing. If you really enjoy my content, you can join my Discord server and chat with me, or you can become a channel member by clicking the join button next to the subscribe button. Special thanks to Bothered Nickel, RustyDO, Mr. Navila, Ray, Arson String, Martin Erickson, Philip McGyar, and Apotilus Tatiri for supporting me, and thank you guys so much for over 10,800 subscribers.